A mass killing inspired by hate is, sadly, nothing new. One alleged gunman espoused white supremacist rhetoric against an Hispanic invasion before a massacre in El Paso, Texas. Another warned of a Jewish invasion before the synagogue shooting in Pittsburgh. And now, white replacement theory was cited by the alleged shooter of black Americans in Buffalo. What is new and disturbing is the growing embrace of that conspiracy in the U.S. that white culture and white supremacy are being replaced by the power of immigrants and other minorities.
That's what's happening, actually. Let's just say it. That's true.
It's a message heard today on mainstream media.
I have less political power because they're importing a brand new electorate. Why should I sit back and take that?
New York's governor says that rhetoric is selling us versus them.
The immigrants, the Jews, the blacks are coming after us, the white people in this country.
Some critics say President Trump's tolerance for the fringe right was a springboard for white grievance.
This is not a right-wing problem. This is a left-wing.
He became sort of a mouthpiece for a lot of these fringe right-wing movements that have gradually over time now become much more embraced by people who are working in Congress, people in popular media outlets like Tucker Carlson.
The lawyer for one Buffalo family says victims must use the law to hold those responsible for providing a platform for racial hatred.
The people who inspire the hate on websites and internet services and cable news stations, those people who radicalize these young people.
The killing of Muslims at a mosque in Quebec in 2017 and the vehicle killing of a Muslim family in London, Ontario last year show this country is not immune.
Those pieces are absolutely here in the Canadian context. The fear of the other overcoming us numerically and politically and socially.
Barbara Perry says in this country, just as the FBI says in the U.S., the greatest domestic terror threat today is homegrown racial hatred. Buffalo, apparently the latest example. Eric Sorensen, Global News, Toronto.